So I'm in my Model Y, obviously. This car is now 15 months old, would you believe it? But anyway, this morning I've had another software update. In fact, it was three updates came down all at the same time. So I'm now on version 2025.2.6, but 0.3 and 0.2 all came down together. So in this video, I'm just going to talk about this update, which is the third-party fast charging preconditioning. So what this update does is precondition the battery if you're going to go off and rapid charge your car. And the Tesla has done that for some time when you're navigating to a supercharger. So if I navigate to a supercharger and let's select my local one, which is Redbridge at Oxford, and I say I want to go there, it should start preconditioning. There we go. And I can hear the heat pumps come on. So it is now warming the battery up. So when I get to that supercharger, the battery will be a bit warmer and therefore the car will charge quicker. So I can now hear that heat pump under the bonnet whizzing away, heating up that battery pack. And actually on these, not only have they got a heat pump, but they've also got something called an Octovalve. And that's a very clever bit of kit that Teslas have. And if you want to know more about those, I'll put a link below to a video that's really interesting. And it shows you how the Octovalve works. It's a long video, but it is well worth a watch, because on the Teslas, the way they scavenge heat from different parts of the powertrain is just really interesting. And they'll even run the inverters on the electric motors inefficiently to make the circuit boards hot so they can generate a bit more heat to put it back into the battery pack or the cabin when it's really cold. It's just very, very clever what Tesla are doing with their heat pump. But anyway, that's now preconditioning the battery. So when I arrive at that supercharger in 25 minutes time, the battery pack on the car will be a bit warmer and therefore it can charge a bit quicker. And the whole point of that is really to maximize the efficiency of the charger site. So you're not hogging that charger for a long time. So you'll free up that stall to allow other people to charge their vehicles. So Tesla implemented this so their charging sites got more efficient and they could have a higher throughput of cars and they could charge more cars without installing more stalls or installing new charger sites. But let's end that. So now they've implemented this preconditioning when you charge at a non-Tesla supercharger. So let's try something else. Let's go to a GridServe site here and navigate to a GridServe charger. And there we go. It's now doing the preconditioning as well. So that's what that update does. So not only does it mean the car will charge quicker when I get to this GridServe charger, but also obviously I'm going to disconnect sooner and free up that charger so someone else can use it. So I'm going to end that. I can now hear the heat pump turning off. So let's just see whether there was anything else in this latest update or set of updates that is worth noting. So the latest one is just minor fixes. I was hoping that there would be the cabin radar in there, but at the moment that isn't in there, which is a shame. Some of you may have seen my previous video I made on that. So in the previous update, just minor fixes and performance enhancements, including security improvements. And then we've got this third-party preconditioning. We've also got a rear cross-traffic chime. And that's when you're reversing, if there's something in one of your blind spots when you're pulling out in traffic or there's a pedestrian walking across the pavement at your rear end, it puts a red bar up on the camera feed, but it will now also chime as well. And then some other updates. So the weather information is now displayed for both the final destination and the waypoints. So just other updates. So that's it. So primarily, I just wanted to show you this preconditioning, because not only does that benefit you as the driver, it also benefits everyone else, because you're going to be at that public charger for the least amount of time as possible. But anyway, just another example that Teslas just keep getting better over time because of these free over-the-air updates, and they keep making improvements and adding new functionality. And of course, as a driver, you don't pay anything for that. So that will do for this video. If you found it useful or interesting, as always, please do click the thumbs up. If you want to know more about the Tesla Model Y, below will be a link to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made. And if you're thinking about buying a Tesla, I'll also include my referral link there, which will get you money off your new car. Okie doke, I'll see you on the next one.